came from Africa a long time ago.
Hi everybody.
Hi.
This is the HD Project. Hikaru Davis speaking.
Emir Ksasan, Uncle Emir.
Yes. Emir. Hi everybody.
Where are we?
We are at the North Academic Center in Harlem.
In Harlem, 138th Street and Convent Avenue. This is City College. I went to City College. Yeah, back in Honolulu. And we did a lot of things here. I told you about some of them, but that's all right.
Okay.
Talk to me, brother.
Okay. And you can see we're in a different area.
Yes.
Ooh la la. How did you meet my dad?
Oh, let's see. It was a long, long, long time ago. I had gone up to Chelsea, that's up around 9th Avenue and 26th Street. There was a music program there, and your dad was part of the music program in Hudson Guild. And when I went inside, there were some people there, and you know, introduced, and then I heard him. I didn't know who he was till I heard him.
What year was that?
Oh, wow. It was in the 60s. 1960. Not 1960, but in the 60s.
60-old?
Or the 70s, early 70s. No, it's 60s. Okay. Yeah, somewhere in the late 60s.
Okay.
Yeah.
What kind of young man was my dad?
Well, first of all, your dad was really talented, because the first time I met him and I heard him on the drums, I said, wow, what a drummer. I like him. See, I was a bass player, so you know, bass players like drummers.
How did my dad's drumming impact your playing as a bass player?
Oh, that's a very good question. Your dad, he liked to play up on the beat. He liked to push it. In other words, the way he would play, he would like just ease in on top of the beat just before it hit. That made the beat push. And I liked that because it gave me a lot of creative things that I could do with it. And we worked well together.
What is your favorite song of Dennis drumming and why?
Oh, wow. You got some really good questions.
Thank
My
you.
My favorite song. I think it was a song that he wrote. Now, if I have to pick a song, I really like them all, but it was a song he wrote that we did with Roy Ayers on Red, Black, and Green. That was a really hot album back in the 60s or the early 70s. I can't remember that far. Rhythms of Your Mind. You know what that was about?
No.
Your dad was about the rhythm is in your body, it's in your heart, it's in your blood. All of that hooks up and it connects with your head, and your brain is in your head, so the rhythms of your mind. And when you think in rhythms. You know, you think, I'm gonna do this, so you work out a beat to it and you make it happen, and the next thing you've done that, now you gotta move on to something. So you got a rhythm going, you know, so rhythms of your, I don't know. But that's what it kind of meant to me. I really liked the song. It was really good.
Could you please give me an advice, something my dad would tell me?
Some advice? Oh, wait a minute. I have to change glasses for that. Okay.
Learn some swag.
Okay. Some fatherly advice from your uncle. Take good care of your mom.
Mom's back there, everybody.
Take good care of her throughout your life. Always keep her in front, you know, so that you know that she's okay. Oh, you want her in the interview now?
Yes, I want her
in the
interview. Mom,
uh-oh.
Come.
Wait. You could have her after me. Right now, let me finish telling you. Also, study seriously. Your dad wants you to be a scholar. In other words, he wants you to go to school, he wants you to have goals, and he also wants you to be happy. So if you can do those things, he's happy. I'll be real happy.
Why was Dennis Davis a good drummer?
He was blessed. He got to hang out with great drummers like Elvin Jones. That was one of his favorite drummers, Elvin Jones, who was probably one of the best drummers in history. He got turned on to music very early. And when you start early on things, you grow. So when I met him, I wasn't playing the bass that long. I was only playing like a couple of years. He had been playing like maybe 10 years already. So he was already a teenager. And I was still, you know, like a toddler trying to learn to walk. He was really good. I have some questions for you. Yes.
Wow.
Let me see your question book. Oh, well, you need to open it. I don't know where you were looking. What do you call this book?
I think it's a notebook.
It's
called a notebook, see?
Okay, let me see your interview questions. I know you're, okay.
That's the second page.
Could you please give me some advice for all the kids that are watching this about how to learn to interview?
So you gotta keep calm, okay? You gotta keep calm. Make it a little funny. Add some funny business. Add commercials. And make good questions, everybody, okay? Good questions. And have a notebook with you.
Good notebook.
Good.
Okay.
Good question.
All right. How did you meet your dad?
I was born into the world.
Yes. So, how did you meet him?
So, I came out of my mom's tummy.
Yeah.
They took me. They washed me and do stuff with me. I don't know what they did.
Ooh.
And then they took me out and then showed me to my dad.
And that was it. Okay. If your dad was still here, what would you tell him?
Me?
Yes.
Tell him.
Yes.
Stay in school.
You want your dad to go back to school? No, I think that's interesting.
Nah, I'm just joking.
You wouldn't ask him to go back to school?
Nah. No. Read more?
Okay.
Write more.
Write more.
Better handwriting.
Right. Well, your dad was a songwriter, so writing is important. Yes.
If Dennis was still here, what would you tell him?
I still have your father. He's in my heart. I think about him a lot. I miss him. But I feel him.
Okay.
And all I could say is keep on playing and make it so I could hear it. And if I hear it, I'm going to play too.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. That's all the questions we have today, everybody.
Oh. I got one.
Have a nice day. Ba-ba-da-ba-da. And subscribe and leave a like if you like the video. Tell me anything in the comments if you think who I should interview next. Bye.